How to create a material item. First, navigate to Main Menu, Setup and then Materials and Inventory. To create a new material item, you must first select the material category from the category drop-down list. In this example, we want to create an ink material, so we will select the ink material category. You can view all the materials that's already created by clicking View. Now to create the new material item, click New. The edit window will open. First enter the description. Click on the code button to generate a unique code for the material item or enter your own. You can link the material item to a subcategory if necessary. To create a subcategory, click on the edit icon. A lookup list window will appear. Enter the description of the subcategory and click OK. Now select the newly created subcategory from the category drop-down list. If the material item is produced for a specific customer, you can select the customer from the customer drop-down list. In this case, we'll leave this field empty because this material item can be used for any customer. Next, select the material type, replenishment method, and resolve method from the drop-down lists. Enter the dimensions and weight of the material item. The quotation settings are set by default. Change them if necessary. Click Save. Next, navigate to units and prices. Select the VAT type and whether it is included or excluded from the cost price. Enter the cost and sell price. Press Enter or click Save. The other fields will automatically populate. Next, you can list all the suppliers where you can purchase this material item from. To add a supplier, click Add. Select the supplier from the drop-down list. Enter the supplier's costs and quantities. Press Enter or click Save. The total field will automatically populate. Next, navigate to Image and Specs. Here you can insert an image and write specifications for the material item. To insert an image, right-click and select Paste if an image was copied, or load to select the desired image. Next, enter the specifications for the material item by simply clicking in the specification field, or click on the Edit button. Click Save. Next, navigate to Instructions. Here you can enter any instructions relating to the material item. In this case, we'll leave it blank. Next, navigate to Dependencies. Here all the estimates and processes linked to this material will be listed. In this case, this field is empty because nothing is linked to this material yet. Next, navigate to Price History. Any price changes and adjustment against this material item will be listed here. So for example, if you change anything in units and prices, it will be shown in price history. If you are satisfied with the newly created material item, click Close. You'll see the newly created material item listed under Materials and Inventory. If you want to add this newly created material item to the inventory, edit the material, click on the Menu button and select Add to Inventory. Now the Inventory and Transactions tab will be available. In the Inventory tab, you can enter the location, bin number, minimum quantity, reorder quantity, lead days and the unit price. If this material item is stored at another location, you can add another location by clicking Add. Click Save. For the in-stock and available fields to be populated, you must first do a stock check. Once the stock check has been done, the in-stock and available fields will be populated. If the material item is linked to a transaction, the on-order and reserved fields will populate and influence the available field. All the linked transactions will be listed in the Transactions tab. When you are satisfied, close the window. You'll see the material item listed in Materials and Inventory with its combined locations stock quantities displayed. If you tick the Inventory Items Filter checkbox and click View, you'll see the inventory material item listed in the data grid,